Tractate Bavabatra, page 120, 8 lines from the top of the page. The subject of age, when it's come to, for example, a wedding, a marriage, it's a sensitive subject. As many of you know, that people are judging sometimes by the age of a person. I'd like to share with you a story about a great rabbi in Vilna. And that rabbi in Vilna, whose name is Salman of Vilna, he brought to his rabbinic bet din, rabbinic court, a case of a mechutan, a father of a man who claimed a week after his son got married to a girl that the age was not truth, which means he understand that his son's going to marry with a girl with a certain age, and it turns that she have about 10 years older than the age that was presented. Obviously, the Rav of Vilna brought examples from our sugiya, which is the idea of the age in our tradition makes a difference up to the moment that they are under the chuppah canopy. The moment they are already a married couple, it doesn't make a difference. Because the source is the daughter of Tzlofchad, which we studied in the past several days. The Torah tells us that is a different list. Two times it mentions the names, but in different orders. One is by the age, another one is by the wisdom, righteousness. So here we are, 120, 8 lines from the top of the page. So they said, Vayikach, Vayachazor mibayale. The Torah said, the father of Moshe Rabbeinu divorced his wife. It was obviously in that time a lot of crisis, and it was the decree of Pharaoh, as the Torah mentioned, to get rid of every baby boy. So he divorced and have her back, his wife. So Yocheved. So Amram, the Torah should use the term Vayachazor, which means he brought her back to their marriage. So Amar Rav Yehuda Bar Zvida Melamed Sha'asa La Ma'aseh Lekuchin, which means even it was a second marriage, he treated her in a way, as the Gemara in Sota, page 12 said, as the first marriage. So since he was the head of the generation, and when he divorced his wife, everyone followed. And the Midrash, the Gemara said that Miriam came and she said that you are severe in your decree than Pharaoh, because Pharaoh commanded to kill all the baby boy, you're killing families. So he have her back. And the Gemara in Sota 12 said that everyone followed him. So anyway, you ever heard the term monkey does man? Anyway, so that's the concept, that everyone followed him. So they said, Hoshiva ba'apiryon. So Apiryon, it was in those days a place that they used to put the chuppah canopy. So they used to carry them. If you look at the old movies, you see it, they carry them. And they said, Aaron and Miriam mishorerim lefanea. So Aaron and Miriam, they basically dance or sing before her, because they knew that the future, is in sense of prophecy, the future redeemer of the Jewish people will come out of that unity. So the Marsha said, because they also knew the miracle involved with the rejuvenations. But anyway, some say that they dance, some say that they sing. You have to zoom in the Gemara in Sota 12 to see the different view. But anyway, Malachi Sharet Omrim Em Habanim Smecha. And the ministering angels are saying from the Psalm 113, a joyful mother of children. Obviously, Yocheved was happy to see her son Aharon and a daughter Miriam. And obviously, as we said, that also it was a lot of sense of prophecy that Moshe Rabbeinu is going to come out of this. Now, Lehalan, some say that that's continuation of the previous statement, but anyway, the Gemara tells us in the based on the Pasuk Bamidbar 36, Mena'an hakatuv derech gdulatan. The Torah said, all the five doors of Tzlofchad, they put it in the list. First one is Machla, Tirza, Chogla, Milka, Noah, have a certain order, which means that you go by the age. Because usually, as we learn from the famous story of the Yaakov and Lavan in the Bereshit 29, that you don't marry the young before the old. At least you try. But they said, V'chan der chokhmatam. But here, they said, V'ele shmo, these are the least, Machla, Noah, V'chogla, U'milka, U'tirza. So you see here, the order is different with the daughters. So obviously it's the idea of the not the age, the wisdom. As we say, the derivative from that, by halacha, up to the time that they're under the chuppah, is one thing. But the moment they marry, it's a unit, it's a married couple, then you can go after the idea of wasn't truthful with the exact age of a person. But anyway, Mesayel el Rabbi Ami. Tamar Rabbi Ami b'yeshiva, when they convene for the Torah matter, for the discussion of Torah, Halech achar chorchma. You should go by the person who is the highest wisdom, not age. Sometimes you have people with a young age that have a tremendous amount of wisdom and piety. And you derive it from the story of five daughters of Tzlofchad. However, Bim Siba, which is literally party, but the idea is in gathering of people for the purpose of celebration, Halech Achar Zikna. You go by the respect of the age. They already are 244 say that in the marriage you should do it for that. The truth is you go to the in China, for example, they the older the person, they give more respect. Anyway, Amar Vashi, they call over there the religion Confucianism. The part of their theory is the idea that the oldest the man, the more wisdom he carries, and therefore they almost worship the age. Amar Rav Ashi, when it's come to the matter of Torah, the person who is a Torah scholar take precedence before this someone who is older in age from him. They said v'hu demiflig b'chokhmah. They said that it's not just a wise sage, someone who's super erudite, right? Someone who's a tremendous wisdom. So the v'hu demiflig b'zikna. And when we say that you take in gathering for celebration the elders, so it means that he's really old in age. It's a matter of fact that late Rav Shach, Rav Eliashiv, have both, they passed the age of 100, the tremendous wisdom and age. Someone told me that the late Rav Eliashiv, before he passed away, he had more than 100 grandchildren, someone told me. Anyway, or grandchildren with the great-grandchildren, something like that. Anyway, Tana Dever Rabbi Ishmael, Bnot Tzlofchad Shkulot Hayu. So, there are, again, here's the expression of wisdom that the Ritva said in all manners they supersede anyone else in wisdom, in piety, in humbleness. So that's basically proof what Rabbi Ami said, Rashbam tells us. Sheneemar Vatiyena, they basically, as we explained yesterday, they married to their cousins because they deserve such a high quality man, and those are really those who deserve to have such a high quality wives. So because the word Vatiyena appear superfluous, Havaya Achat Lechulan, they have all high spiritual level. another point, אמר רב יהודה אמר שמואל בנו צלף חד ותחו להינשא לכל השבטים. Usually, if you remember, we talk about it in the past, there is a prohibition, at least the first generation, to marry out of their tribes. They tried to divide the tribe by certain property, they gave a lottery, so they do not want the daughters to go and marry out of the tribe, and then basically lose some of the properties, problem. But by them it was the exception, שנאמר לטוב ביניהם תהיינה לנשים. So the Moses said, in behalf of God, whatever they wish, they will marry. אלא מה אני מקיים אך למשפחת מתי אביהם תהיינה לנשים? עצה טובה ישיאן הכתוב שלא ינסו אלא להגון להם. That's what we said yesterday, that that in a way the Almighty said to Moses to hand over to them the notion that they should look for some caliber, some high caliber man that really deserves such a wife. The Meshe Chochma and Torat Mimar of Epstein on Bamidbar 27:7 have a lot to say about it. But anyway, let's continue. Motiv Rabba, Emor Lahem, Lotam Aumdim Al Har Sinai. We're getting close to Shavuot. Those people who get close to her, to those to receive the time, the Aseret HaDibrot, so they over there there is a Isur Achilat Kodashim Betumah, the prohibition against eating a consecrated item while the body is not in a total ritual purity. So לאותם עומדים על הר סיני לדורותיכם, אלו דורות הבאים. אם נאמר אבות, למה נאמר בנים? ואם נאמר בנים, למה נאמר אבות? מפני שיש באבות מה שאין בבנים, ויש בבנים מה שאין באבות. באבות הוא אומר, וכל בת יורשת נחלה, והרבה מצוות נצטוו בנים שלא נצטוו אבות. So you have here a separation. The fathers have certain מצוות that commanded for them, but not to the sons, and vice versa. מפני שיש באבות שאין בבנים, ויש בנים מה שאין באבות, הוא צריך לומר אבות, והוא צריך לומר בנים. So קטן המיה באבות, הוא אומר, וכל בת יורשת נחלה. When it's come to the fathers, the Torah said, and every daughter who possesses an inheritance. So it means that it was a mitzvah for the entire generation, including Tzlofchad's daughter, in contrast to the statement of Shmuel. So the Gemara said, קטן המיד באבות, הוא אומר, בכל בת יורשת נחלה, הוא מוטיב לה והוא מפרק לה. רבא challenge here, which Shmuel said, and he himself said that that's applied to that generation. Levar mibnot Tzlofchad. The exception is the daughter of Tzlofchad were explicitly permitted to marry members of any tribe. This is what the Amek Devar said, because of their importance, the Almighty make it easy for them, or to show them respect. The Orachaim HaKadosh on Bamidbar 36 said that it's an expression of respect. But anyway, Amar Mar, באבות הוא אומר, וכל בת יורש נחלה, באבות אין, בבנים לא, מה עם האשמה? אמר רבא, אמר קרא, זה הדבר, הדבר זה לא ינוהג אלא בדור זה. This specifically will be in that generation. Anytime the Torah used the term זה הדבר, it's something that applies to that specific moment, to that צו השראה. Anyway, is a Ramban that in Malbim over there that explained it at length. אמר לרבא בר זוטי, אמר לרבא זוטי לרב אשי, אלא מעתה זה הדבר, אך אינם לא יהיה נוהג אלא בדור זה, שענתם דכתיב לדורותם. So they said for that generation. So you see here the prohibition is in effect in all generation. Page 120b, זה הדבר, here is the portion that deal with the law of vows, in the book of Bamidbar, chapter 30, דרשי הרמתות, החינמי דלא ינוהג, אלא בדור זה. The whole idea of law of vows should apply to that specific generation. אמר לי, ההוא, Yalif ze, ze mehatam. Because we use a verbal juxtaposition, that they use the word ze, meaning this, in the sense of the text that speaks about the law of vows, and this that we learn in the offering, the law of offering the slaughter outside of the tabernacle of the or the Beit HaMikdash, the temple, which is applicable in all generations. So the verbal juxtaposition apply le dorot, not just that time but also the future. So the Gemara challenged and said, "Hai namel leilaf ze ze me'atam." We should know the same thing, that the daughter we inherited cannot marry to someone from different tribes. So they said, we should learn the same idea of Shchutei Chutz, that some slaughter outside of the temple. So they should use the same verbal analogy. That's also applied to the future generations. So they said, Hai Mai, how come you compare? How you juxtapose the two? How do you say it in English? You can compare apple to oranges? It's two different things, right? Bishlama hatam itztrich legzera shava. Over there, you learn in the sense of a verbal analogy. The therefore, you need it. The hacha lemai itztrich. Why you need the zeh adavar? Lishtok kra mine ve'ana yadana ledlorotu. And we by ourselves will know that that's applied to the future generation. The same way is applied to all the other mitzvot. So the Rashbam said that the derivative is that this prohibition not applies to a few generations as well. Now, my gzera shava. So what is the verbal analogy for which the pasuk was necessary? The Tanya, we learn in the Braita. The Markan, we learn the law of annulment of vow. זה הדבר, ונאמר להלן, ונאמר להלן, זה הדבר. Both times they use the term, this is the matter. So since we use, as Rabbi Ishmael teaches us, the verbal analogy in a juxtaposition between the two, so we learn, מה להלן, over there, they come to the law of slaughtering outside of the temple. You talk about Aaron ובניו וכל ישראל, אף כאן Aaron ובניו וכל ישראל. ומכאן ראשי המטות, אף להלן ראשי המטות, the head of the tribes. אמר מרמה להלן אהרון ובנה וכל ישראל, אף כאן אהרון ובנה וכל ישראל, למה היא הלכתה? אמר אך אבר יעקב לומר, שהפרת נדרים בשלושה אדיוטות. So basically you need three laymen in order to abrogate it, in order to annul vows. In general, people think that you need a regular form of the scholar of Bet Din when it's come to annulment, but the truth is not. You see it in the Erev Rosh Hashanah when people open the Sidurim. You see it in the Art School Sidurim, right? When people does the Al-Koran, you see at Atarat Nedarim, the annulment of vows. So you can have three laymen that had your thought, not mumchim, not an expert, as long as the part of the Bet Din of three people. Chazon Ish didn't like it. There's a famous story about him that he was very strong, adamantly, to have people who really know. But most of the people don't go by that. Anyway, והא ראשי המטות כתיב בי, כי דאמר רב חיסדא אמר רבי יוחנן, ביחיד מומחה, ההכנה מביחיד מומחה. ומה כאן ראשי המטות? אף כאן ראשי המטות. So they said, למה הלכתה? Why you have to connect the head of the tribes, the law of slaughtering outside of the temple? אמר רב ששת לומר שיש שאלה בהקדש. He said that it's that the concept of requesting the solution of consecration, of consecrated property, just as one can request the solution of a vow. אמר רב ששת לומר שיש שאלה בהקדש. So it means you can go before the Torah scholar Chacham, or Bedin of at least three laymen, and they can basically have atarat nedarim, annulment of the vows. That's a derivative from that verbal analogy. Tosfot read in Nedarim 21 elaborates on that. But anyway, ulebeit shamai damre en shela beegdesh detnan. That's the Mishnah in Nazir, page 30. Beit Shammai, Hekdesh Taut Hekdesh. If someone consecrated by mistake, it's still considered consecration. But Hekdesh, So that's if someone said a black ox that come out of my house, the first one should be a consecrated one, and the first one came out is white, right? White ox. So according to Beit Shammai, the white oxen is consecrated, is hegdish, because he intend to consecrate the first one. Beit Hillel said that it's not, because it's all mistaken, it's all made by in error. So they said, "Hai zevze ma abdele," because they use it in both annulment of vow and slaughter outside of the temple. So they said, "Zeh levar deshchutei chutz mibayle." Al ha-shochet hu chayav, ve'eno chayav al ha-molek. זה הדבר לראשי עמדות, בבעל חכם מתיר ואין בעל מתיר, בעל מפל ואין חכם. So again, here we have to differentiate when it's come to the law of שחיטה between one whose slaughter for pinching the neck of consecrating a bird outside the tabernacle or the temple, which is excluded from the category of slaughtering the mitzvah. And the same applies to the others, that a husband can dissolve the Rashi HaMatot, the scholar can dissolve not husband, but when it's come to the regular matter of Nedarim, the husband-wife, so husband can nullify his wife or his daughter's vow on the day that he hears the vow, regardless of her mindset. But the halachic authority cannot nullify the vow in this matter. ולבית שמע דלת לו גזרה שווה, הפרד נתרים בשלושה דודות מנהלו, נפקלו מדתניה ולבר משה את מועדי השם לבני ישראל. רבי יוסי הגלילי אומר, Page 121, מועדי השם נאמרו, שבת בראשית לא נאמרה. So basically the Rashbam explained that the Chazal, the sages used the term שבת בראשית to emphasize, because there are מועדים also called שבת or שבתון, they want to emphasize that God ויקדש אותו, that God sanctified the Shabbat, and therefore it's written that way. But anyway, בן עזר אומר, מועדי השם נאמרו, הפרת נדרים לא נאמרה. The festival of the מועדים, so it's stated, but the solution of the vow is not. So that's basically the conclusion of the Braita. רבי יוסי בר נתן גמיר למעלה מתנינתא ולא ידע לפירושה. עוד exactly the משנה meant. עזל בטריד רב ששת לנהרדה. So he was searching for רב ששת לנהרדה, that he thought that he would find him there, in order to clarify it, the Braita, ולא אשכחי, כולם פיינים, מזל בתחיל למחוז האשכחי. אמר לי, מאי, מועדי השם נאמרו, שבת בראשית לא נאמרה. Why you said the festival, but not בראשית? אמר לי, מועדי השם צריכים קידוש בדין. So, as in those days, they need to be בדין to signify the certain day, the month. So that's basically the chalot, the time that you can have the moed is based on the Beit Din. So all the time during the Tanakh, during the time of the era of the first, second temple, the time of the Mishnah, even the time of Abaye and Rava, it wasn't a stated clear calendar as we have nowadays. So therefore you have the Beit Din HaGadol that used to go and send, and then they send the people and they make a certain time for Kiddush HaChodesh, as the Rambam tells us. So that's basically the story. So so Shabbat Bereshit not צריך קידוש לבית דין. סגר התחה מן האול ובכתי לגבי מועדות טיבאי קידוש בית דין כמועדות. כמה שמלן, מהי מועדי השם נאמרו הפרת נדרים לא נדרה? מועדי השם צריכים מומחים, in order to sanctify the new months, that's what the Yevanim try to eliminate, because that's one of the things that show the real power of the rabbis, that they sanctify and they make decision when exactly it should be. And that's the origination, even the most expert at the earliest time was Moshe Rabbeinu, but God asked him to combine Aaron with him in order to make it kachem, that you have to have, as dayanim mumchim, they have to have a group together. Now, you have to have bedin shakul, you have to have bedin of three, as the Gemara in Sanhedrin 2 said. This is here, you have Moshe Aaron. So therefore, you add another one. That's the Rashbam said based on Rosh Hashanah 25. The Rambam in Ilchot Kiddush HaChodesh, chapter 5, elaborate the whole process of Kiddush HaChodesh. You're welcome to see, to read it. V'ar Hashem HaTuktiv, Amar Rav Chisda, Amar Rabbi Yochanan, B'yachid Mumche. So over there, they speak about single erudite expert authority. So as you see, that the Gemara rules that Beit Shammai can derive the dissolution of vow, can be performed by laymen. In the matter that Rabbi Nazai said, and as Rav Sheshet explains, the Rambam, the vignette in the Ilchot Kiddush HaChodesh, chapter 5, said the termination and sanctification of the new moon and the intercalation of the year can be executed only by the Sanhedrin in Eretz Israel or by the rabbinic court of ordained judges in Eretz Israel that has been licensed for this task by the Sanhedrin. At present, when there is no Sanhedrin, the termination of month and intercalation of year is done only in accordance with the calculation that was transmitted to us. And that's also you see it in Sefer HaMitzvot, in a positive mitzvah 153. So, in general, as we said, that the whole concept of Ilchot Kiddush HaChodesh, the first chapter in the Rambam, it's very important. If you get a chance, read it, it's beautiful.